No. Let's see. My name is Tove Styrke, and I'm a Swedish artist, singer, songwriter, creator of things. I just feel like I'm way more relaxed this time around than I've ever been. I've really been the type of person a lot in my life who like tries to, for some reason, it's so hard to fight the urge to just like try and make everything perfect. Like, as soon as I'm like making stuff and like putting stuff out, I want to Beyonce this shit and be like, hey, yes, this is everything is like, no room for misinterpretations, like, ding, ding. And like, I worked so many hours on like making everything just like perfect the last time. And this time I just felt like I don't care, like it's not rocket science, it's pop. It's supposed to just like be communication, and it's gonna be so much more interesting if I edit myself less, I think. I'm like grown enough and talented enough to not edit the shit out of myself. So that's sort of where I am now. Long answers all the time. Okay, the video idea. I thought it would be so interesting to have one person portray a couple of visually drastically different characters. Okay. Hi Vogue Scandinavia, I'm Tove Styrke and this is my video for Mood Swings.
Thing you knew?
Oh my god, Mood Swings, this whole project, like this song and this video and the pictures and everything, I'm obsessed with it, I love it so much.
She's done some digging. These are definitely the highest shoes I've ever worn. Listen to my new song, Mood Swings. It's out everywhere now!
A lot of the style for the video and the characters were based off of specific like brands and designers. Miu Miu / Prada vibe for the gray character. We had the McQueen vibe for the creature. The one with the tubes, Elliot. Comme des Garçons, like a little bit of Rick Owens, a little bit of McQueen there too, and like just DIY, like this person like created their own religion for themselves almost. Pam, cheaper like influencer brands. That's like her vibe. She's the only one who doesn't have luxury brands because that's not on brand for her. I love her so much. That's also like one of my favorites.
I literally can't see. It's a death trap, but it's worth it.
Yeah. Like, the makeup team were up at 4 a.m, painting me while I was asleep, like in her apartment.
My whole body's white.
That's not normal. People don't usually do that. Like, everybody went in. So like as soon as we were done with one character, I had to run. Like I didn't get pee breaks. I peed in the shower when I got the paint off. They were like, "Honey, you're allowed. We know you can't go otherwise." One thing that was really important with this project was to treat the characters in a loving way and in a respectful way, and they had to have depth and thought. Yeah, I really feel like the fashion was a huge part of making them, giving them depth, giving them like some solid foundation to like stand on visually. I think fashion influences are like so hard to just like name a few, because I really feel like I get so much inspiration just like every day on like Instagram. I have this folder where I just like keep that I call, I think, fun brands, where I save everything from like people knitting strawberry hats to like really hype new cool brands that Kylie Jenner wears. Like, it's like everything. So it's hard to like pin down a few. I find so much stuff online, and just like also like people, like. Just like on TikTok the other day, for instance, I saw this girl who like, she was so cool on roller skates, and just like, she had like the best style with like her knee pads and like her little tank tops and like her very like LA, I don't care, like vibe, and like, I wanna be like her. Like, that's sort of where you get inspiration from, really. We as humans, we're so much more complex on the inside and so much more like versatile and like diverse than we really get credit for oftentimes. We love to like put people in these like little neat tiny boxes, and I hate that. I hate it so much. And I thought this was such a like cool idea to sort of like flip that notion and create something where like one person actually just like looks and like portrays different people like looking very, very different, while we have no idea what they're actually like, what they've been through, what they're feeling, who they are. We don't know. Maybe they feel exactly the same. Maybe they're drastically different on the inside as they are on the outside.
look at her face. Isn't that stunning?
Super.
Thank you.